This is Tea Time on Plus TV Africa, where we're bringing the biggest sentiment stories. My name is Elsie Godwin, and I have my interesting co-anchors with me, Ife Omai and Ife Oluwa Oshoke.
If Ife can, Ife will take the gist that we have backstage. I'm like, guys, just hold on for a second. No. Forget Tea Time. Let's just gist about what we were gisting about.
Ife, how is your girlfriend?
Why do you have to do that?
But how is your girlfriend?
She's very well, thank
your
you.
Your audio girl.
And everything is... No, is it audio?
If I think she's audio.
I think she's
But is she audio?
Audio.
She's not audio.
Okay, so everything is fine.
Yeah, so you guys...
You are not cheating.
Do you want to meet my girlfriend for real?
Which
After
one?
Lockdown.
It's either she doesn't exist or there's many of them. Mm. But I know there's not just one girl. I know.
Nah, there's not just one girl.
So if it's just one girl, mention her name.
No, but that would mean I would
time,
have to tell you.
Time is running.
Well,
let's
I have to tell
on.
You who my girlfriend is, but I think I'd rather keep my private life private because...
Your girlfriend is not the only one bearing that name, I'm sure.
No, my private life is private. You're not going to push me to mention my girlfriend's name, but I have a girlfriend happily involved in a very active, non-audio relationship, and it's a one-guy relationship, one girl, one guy relationship, whichever way is okay. Vice versa.
Hi, girlfriends. All right, moving on.
Well, she's one
yeah,
in a million.
Let's move on,
so
fam.
Yeah, you can use S for her.
Mm, want to make the whole time about your girlfriend.
You just
point
don't
that.
Leave me. Don't leave me.
Beyoncé has announced a new visual album called Black is King, set to be launched on Disney Plus on July 31st. The visual album is based on her 2019 LP, The Gift. In a statement, Disney said, quote, "This visual album from Beyoncé reimagines the lessons of The Lion King for today's young kings and queens in search of their crowns," end of quote. Beyoncé serves as writer, director, and executive producer on the visual album, which will feature videos for The Gift tracks like My Power, Mood Forever, and Brown Skin Girls, as well as appearances by that album's guest artists and some special guests, quote unquote. Mm. Yeah.
I think she's been really dabbling into like visuals a lot.
This is the second
more.
One, right?
Yeah, but they're beginning to be a lot more symbolic and artistic and also even futuristic a bit with how she mixes everything together. And I think that's really cool. I like that she's being really conscious about it. A lot of the times when people want to achieve something like this, it's always really driven by aesthetics only, like what looks good. But I like that she's taking a step further, apart from looking
conscious.
Good, she'll still kill it, but she's adding a lot of important symbols and history and elements into the artwork. So I want to see what this looks like. I have seen, though, in the Lemonade visuals, a lot of backlash that was there. I'll not bring it up because I know people are going to say that I'm doing too much. But I'm hoping that in this visual that she, you know, does better with how she represents the women more and things like that.
Basically, I like the fact, like you said, the creativity in her visuals are always out of this world. And I like the fact that she's even focusing on a lot of Africanness or Africanism, I would say, because from the preview, you can see kids, black kids with the whole, what's it called now, chalk on their faces and, you know, red and stuff. So it's more like the African vibe. And knowing Beyonce, you know she does the research because by the time she calls some, what's it called, some cults, African cults or some gods in Africa, you see that she actually knows what she's talking about. So I believe that she must have put a lot of work and effort into this. So let's see what comes out of it. It's amazing. So
in less than in 30 days, I guess, or 32 days, we'll see it.
And then Whiskey, I like the course, Brown Skin Girl. Yeah, Whiskey the game. Again and again and again.
Okay, I like the visual idea thing. Now I'm going to sound like all those
pastors.
All those pastors that would say... all those pastors that we, all those people say they're pastors and they're just making things up. Sometimes I believe them because sometimes I felt the way they feel. So you see this whole idea of having an album that is visual. I've thought about this like 10 years ago and I'm like, who is going to do this first? I'm like, Kelly Well. And I'm glad that she did it with Lemonade. And I actually expected that there would be more artists that want to toe that line, but I'm guessing they're not really ready for that.
Oh, I think the person I followed suit was Kelly Rowland in that. Is it Seduce? Is that the name of the song? Or
album?
No, a song.
No, I'm talking of an album, a visual album, basically. Visual, you know, album. And when it happened with Beyoncé, I was like, wow, okay, so you're not the only one thinking about these things in this life. And yeah, so I wish we were in a better environment with more
opportunities for
capacity.
I like what you
say,
you're not the
capacity.
Only one thinking about this because you'll be able to relate it to something else.
Mm-hmm. And I guess that just also validates your ideas, that you actually do have good ideas. Hey, million dollar idea. Get it, girl. Get it.
Beyoncé, you're having ideas.
Wow, so is it only Beyoncé that has ideas?
No, that's what I'm seeing.
Beyoncé is the only person to have really executed it on such a big platform. Yeah. You don't know, actually.
Okay, and I'm sure she's making a kill out of all this because it's always exclusive with this platform and that platform.
But Disney,
you know how much they pay.
Yeah, but it was still a bit. I don't know what's happening with Disney. Maybe I don't know what it is, but I'm getting wowed by the type of people that are associating themselves to Disney lately. I think
sometimes it's consistency.
I think
they're
confused.
You understand?
No, they're confused.
Who, Disney?
Yeah.
I think they just have a lot of money and a lot of resources to really gamble in a lot of things. Because Beyoncé
and Netflix has thrown a lot of people off balance. So they're trying to
They're tested and trusted. So Beyoncé would rather go with somebody that you know would deliver. You know, it's not
because they're not the ones delivering the production. Like, they just have the right to launch it. Yeah. They're not delivering anything. It's the money they're delivering.
Yeah, they're delivering money.
Because even, what's it called? I think it was Tomb Raider. A lot of franchises, like movies that are very mature and very on Disney, like, are giving their franchise to Disney to do the part two, do the part three. I'm like, what is happening with Disney?
They're growing with you, fam. Cool. So moving on. The Nigerian Bar Association, through the Assistant National Publicity Secretary, Habib Lawal, calls out Lasisi Elenu on how he represents lawyers in his jokes. The comic act recently added a new character to his acting called Lawyer Atomic Bomb. Habib called out Lasisi after he posted a new video of the Atomic Bomb on his social media page. According to him, NBA has been tagged and is using Lasisi as a point of reference to all other comedians to represent the profession in their works appropriately. Before we go on, we want to correct something before we go ahead with the Lasisi. Yeah, go ahead.
We mentioned that Beyoncé had the first. Yeah. Well, I think it's a few people. And one that comes to mind was in 2010 with Kanye West. We just found that in research. So, I mean, I still think that's a kill.
I did not get to see Kanye West.
Well, we didn't know that.
And the publicity was not as much.
I don't think it was as powerful as Lemonade. I don't think so.
It didn't have as much impact.
Yeah. Okay, well, kudos to Kanye West.
Yeah, Kanye West does it first, though.
Oh, yeah, Lasisi.
Lasisi. So, NBA. Ife is more related to them than us.
Okay, so, first of all, I'm not related to the NBA.
You are denouncing yourself quickly.
No. We all know that I'm a lawyer.
What did you study in school,
I studied law, but NBA
Ife, you are related
is when
them.
You're called to
if you wake up tomorrow now and say you want to really do this.
Then I would have to go to law school.
And they will call you, think they will never call you?
Okay, but at the end of the day, the only reason why, NBA would refer to someone like Lasisi, maybe if the joke was a bit funny, then maybe,
So you think because the joke wasn't funny?
Yeah, maybe that's why they felt insulted. Like, why are you associating us with this type of boring personality?
I think what Lasisi does is take real life experiences in Nigeria and try to make it funny and exaggerate it. And if you can relate, that's when it will be funny to you. But if you can't relate, then you probably think, okay. What is he doing?
A lot of people are lawyers then because I cannot relate.
You don't need to be a lawyer to have
me. I didn't find 99.999% of most of the comedy skits funny. Especially, it's hard for me to even, like, I can say
Lasisi's
sometimes.
Comedy skits or all comedy skits?
All comedy skits. Especially how you can say, oh, I really like this person. What I find is that one time Talma does really well and then Maraji makes me laugh and they may be judged funny, but like every video I watch and I'll just be laughing. It hasn't happened, and not with Lasisi. But I would say though, Lasisi at the very beginning made me laugh quite often than normal. So, like, and then it just got really boring really quickly.
I think
started to shout too much and it was such a drag.
Exactly. I think they try too hard to to be consistent, but consistency.
But it works for a lot of people. People are still finding it really, really funny.
And people are laughing.
People are laughing.
I am laughing.
We are the minority on this table. You know, trust me.
You know the funny thing is, I don't laugh at every joke. Like especially when you know when we had only just stand up comedy and you have to go to shows and all.
Gosh, so crazy.
That used to be stressful. Because maybe if you tell like 100 jokes, two is making me laugh, and you know, and I was really there to laugh, right? The only people that can take you through that journey from beginning to end is when you're talking of Basket Mouth or Bovi, like they have like a story to what they're doing. But I mean, I love comedy, so when it's not being done well, it can be like you're putting, so, but I think they're doing well.
No,
I think
not doing badly, but
it's
I also
preference.
Want them to know that consistency is not putting out skits every day or every week. Sometimes take your time, be creative about it. Don't feel the need to be pressured that, okay, because I'm Lasisi Eleni, I drop today, I'm a drop tomorrow.
People argue with you, it's all perspective.
Consistency is not that, it's about being able to deliver every single time.
It's delivering to
like
a lot of people,
said,
just not to me.
In the beginning, was super
funny.
He's
got more
funny.
Than 1 million.
That has to do with your humor,
creative.
not his.
Very, but right now, which one is Atomic Bomb? Which lawyer?
Like, well, okay, let's come back to the conversation.
Yeah, mm-hmm. is Atomic
Why
Bomb?
Exactly,
Atomic
yeah, that's Atomic what I'm saying, let's come back. Why exactly is NBA being bothered about what this guy is doing? I think his wig is even looking better than some of the wigs I've seen. I don't know.
No, it's not. But this is not the appropriate outfit. So the inner collar
that's
isn't
why
part
it's a,
of
that's
the
why
uniform.
It's a comedy. That's why it's...
And I think that's what they're trying to correct. That, okay, at least if you want to depict us in a manner, then make sure it's the right manner. And a lot of lawyers...
It's interesting that he said they have the right to do so. But, like, I've always said I don't know anything about law. But I'll put this particular law... issue in the same category as that challenge that those ladies did
exactly.
about uniforms
and
how it's represented and things like that. But I don't know, there's a big difference between those two things because one of them was actually employed on the staff of that place and another is clearly doing comedy. So if you start to, if you can do that with like Lasisi Elenu, who's a comedian, can you do that in a movie role? If I have a movie role and I scatter the uniform and I'm making a joke out of it, can the NBA also attack me?
I like that you're coming from that angle because there's been a lot of movies that I've seen lawyers in and I feel like, man, if this is how lawyers look like, then I don't ever want to be a lawyer, yeah?
But the
why haven't they woken up and tweeted and said something or spoken to the Actors Guild or whatever body they think is in charge to get them to portray them in the best way possible? Why is it Lasisi? I don't know. I think I want to actually believe that this guy is speaking for himself and not for
the association. Well, he actually answered that question.
He's actually
speaking
for the association.
He was speaking for
the
association.
Somebody asked him. Yeah.
It is sacred and you should treat it with care.
They need to get to
caution.
The point where they stop wearing
and
wig
when
and
you're
gown.
Wearing
this
your
sacredness
wig,
is
it's
not,
like when you're wearing
working.
Certain uniforms and you cannot misbehave in those uniforms. That's how you cannot
it's misbehave. That's a very good metaphor for Nigerians. We like holding on to, I was going to swear about one TV. We like holding on to poop that isn't necessary.
Isn't necessary.
So because you've worn the wig for a while and you know it's already enough, but God forbid I admit that I need to throw away this old tradition. I must, with force and fake pride, stick to something that's not relevant. Why the heck are you wearing a wig in 2020?
And a lot of people are saying that the wig is not even relevant anymore, and that wig represents the colonial masters. I'm not saying this.
It does. It's supposed to be. It's what's supposed to be. What's it called? Mimicking white people hair. So the lawyers used to actually curl their real hair that way because the black people couldn't get their hairs in that shape. We wore a wig and were still wearing the wig. Think about that, NBA. Leave Lasisi and think about that.
I think you should focus on your focus.
Don't leave me, don't leave me.
Some words of wisdom.
Mm-hmm. Okay, very quickly, Funke Akindele's ex-staff is calling her out, saying that she worked in a hostile environment that drained her physically, emotionally, financially, whatever. So,
mentally.
I don't know. Yeah, everything. Everything that has LLY at the end. Yeah.
Surprising.
Is it surprising?
Yeah, because I've heard the opposite from a lot of people, that she's very
Thank
motherly. And
she's worked with?
Yeah, no, yeah, that her, under her, that okay. she has power over
Thank
and
you.
Influence over. It's very like, oh, why she's a mother, away from a business person, she's a mother. Like, that motherly thing is the vibe that I get. But I would say, though, human beings, I've met the sweetest people, and they're not the sweetest people to every
Everyone.
Single person. Mm-hmm. Sometimes your vibe really offs me. Like, if I want to be a nice, I would say person, like, I'm a nice person, but some people I just don't want to be nice to, honestly. And if you're going to go and tweet about me, they'll probably say that all the alleys in this world, I have drained them off. And it's just vibes. Your vibe is just off. I don't
all
find you.
Yes. personally.
Uh-huh. I just don't find you gendered enough. So this could be one of the situations as well, because I think when you start to see like a bigger crowd saying one thing and another person is excluded, I'm not saying that she's lying or whatever. But
what's the point of telling your creative writers or whatever not to watch TV and those things she alleged, really? Because it's weird. Like you said, I mean, I haven't really been close to people who I think would be unbiased when they want to talk about Funke Akindele, because remember also that she's a source of meal to a lot of people in that industry. So it would be kind of difficult to find someone who probably not want to be unbiased, especially in Nigeria, really. So I don't know how this plays out, but I that's the part I picked in her writer, because her video was, I don't know how she talks. It's stressful to actually follow what she's saying through.
Why didn't you just record that video at once?
Yeah, so, but what she wrote is the part I'm focusing on, and I just hope that this is not true. Knowing Funke Akindele, she's probably never going to respond to this anyway.
Not to victim shame this lady, but whatever she said, I totally do not believe until maybe she can get other people, like the people that she said they used to sleep on the floor and all of that.
She can get some of them to speak.
Maybe,
I don't think so. And she actually kind of came off like she wants to use Funke Akindele to glue her vlog. For her, get popularity. So it's just
because
left
I've
and right
heard,
for
I've
me.
Heard too many, I've heard too many
I,
good
I've heard bad things as well.
I guess maybe I'm yes.
Well, I've heard bad things.
I've heard only good
and I've
things
heard more
it's
good
not possible
well,
for someone
so
to have only
okay
good things. That's why I don't really
think... That's why
think
I said I've heard. I'm not saying there are no bad things, but the things I've heard about Funke Akindele
are good, right?
Are good.
I mean, if you hear about me outside, trust me, 100% is going to be bad.
90% of the time I've met Funke Akindele, she was good people.
Yeah, we need to
she can also be bad at big, but whatever.
That's how we wrap up this episode of Tea Time. Thank you for watching, and send your opinions via WhatsApp to 0906000 5719 or tweet at us at Plus TV Africa. Also, catch up on this episode and all exclusive content by subscribing to our YouTube channel at Plus TV Africa. Also, watch Tea Time on Arrow TV and in London on Ben Television. My thank you, as always, go to my co-anchors, Ife Omai. And
yes, that's me.
Okay, now it's contagious, but Ife Oluwaseyi is here as well. So
yes, that's the link.
Thank you for watching Plus TV Africa's Tea Time. My name is Elsie Godwin. Just stay safe.